So, what are my thoughts on Smashing Pumpkins' Oceana album? What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, Cyberland? Coming back to you with another Smashing Pumpkins album review. I'm kind of excited about this one. So with that being said, okay. So at this point, I was seeing YouTube videos. It was clips of people recording of the band playing a couple, like two tracks from this upcoming album. And I gotta say, I liked what I heard. I really, really liked what I heard. It just gave this vibe of just like, this. It was like the sound of, it wasn't, I know we're never gonna get another Siamese and I don't want another one, but it gave me that feeling. It gave me that feeling with Melancholy. It gave me that feeling with those two albums in particular. And so, you know, I remember the album leaked and I listened to it, of course, because I'm going to, but I was already like, I already knew when I saw Billy, like somebody had a video on YouTube and it was from an angle where Billy was playing, and I already knew, okay, I'm going to get this album. I already know. I'm going to listen to it if it leaks, but I'm still buying it. And listen to the album, and it was so refreshing. It was very refreshing. Even though Jimmy wasn't part of the band, but Mike Barn, he did a good job. He was a kid too. I mean, he was like barely in his 20s or something, and Billy hired him. Of course, it didn't last very long, but he did a great job on the song. It was a great album. Everybody was, you know, even though the lady, the bassist, didn't last long. I mean, she wasn't in the band too much longer, but. Everything was good. From track 1 to track 13, I loved everything. I loved the whole album. I mean, Oceana's kind of like, and the song's like, it's a whatever track to me. But I still listen to it. I still can enjoy it. But I don't like it as much as the other stuff. And right away, you're kind of like, dude, like, what the hell were you doing, like, with the Tear Garden part and then coming to this? It's just like, it's kind of like the Tear Garden, it just... They're connected, but they don't feel connected. It's like the Tear Garden's like, okay. And the Oceana's like, way up here. There's a Tear Garden's here, and the Oceana's like, up here. What the hell? It just felt like that. It just, but again, I'm an album person. I love albums. So, you know, my rating for this album is a 5 out of 5. Yes, sirs. That's right. 5 out of 5. Hands down. It was so fulfilling when I heard it. Even when I listen to it, like Quasar is my favorite song on the album. And I'll get it though, but top 5 tracks. Quasar, I always know how to say Panopticon. My Love is Winter. I love My Love is Winter. And then Inkless. And Glissandra. I believe it's Glissandra. But I love Pale Horse too. So yeah. Love Pale Horse. Pale Horse is talking about death, but I love that. Wildflower 2 is a great way to end the album. It's a great way to end the album. And Quasar is a great way to bring into the album. And everything is just, it's on point. Everything's hitting on point. The music is good. The lyrics are good, and it doesn't focus just on, like, it doesn't have to be just full in your face, but when the first track started, I'll just let you know, we're back, you thought I couldn't do this, I couldn't do that, I'll show you, kind of, it just gave that vibe when I heard the first song. I just, you know, I loved everything about it. Yeah, but... and then Billy doing the soloing again. He did. It was more so incorporated into the song to where it wasn't sticking out on its own. But I loved it. I just loved how he did it. I loved how the album was done. It's one of my favorite Smashing Pumpkins albums with Siamese Dream, Melancholy, and this one. I think Makina too, but I'm waiting for that to be done. I gotta hand it down. It's a huge step up from Zeitgeist, even though I like Zeitgeist, but the feeling I got from this album was just good. I hadn't had this feeling since Siamese Dream of Melancholy. That's the truth. I know if Makina had been a double album, it'd probably have been the same vibe, but I haven't felt that since. But I can't wait for that to come out, because I know I'm going to get that vibe again. You can tell. I would say, if you like Smashing Pumpkins, get it, pick it up, listen to it. It's a good album. It's You won't be disappointed. Hands down, it's a great album from top to bottom. And it really shows what Billy can do as being older musician, and that he still has abilities. Now, whether this album is something that made millions of dollars, I don't know if that's the case. But as far as its lasting appeal, it definitely has it. It definitely has that element from top to bottom. I think the only issue with it was that I don't think it got enough recognition as it should have. But maybe that's because the label they were on, all that stuff. Maybe how much it cost to do that, but I loved it. I think he really did a good job with how he did this. Can pick it up, check it out, you won't be disappointed. So, cue the music.